to a new wave, it's a new day. Rise up to the light, the sound is so pure. It's a new wave, it's a new day. In this trying time, what you fight. All right, well, welcome to the first edition of the Junior A Hounds Chat here on Zoom, as we do it in this era. We're going to try to avoid using that magic word, as you guys know the word I'm talking about. It starts with a C and ends in Ovid. But I'm proud and happy to have in the first Junior A Hounds Chat here with two new signings for the Hounds Junior A, but two familiar faces around Wilcox. In the top left of your screen, we've got Blake Rasmussen, and below me, we've got Kevin Anderson. Kev and Blake, thank you guys so much for joining me today.
Thanks for having us, Nukes.
Yeah, thanks for having us. Glad to be here.
First of all, obviously, for those that don't know, I'm Jamie Neugebauer, the broadcaster slash director of communications for the Hounds Junior A, and looking forward to getting back to it. I'll ask you first, Blake, because, you know, you're a little older, I think. How's this off-season been for you in terms of training, in terms of finding ice, trying to stay fit? What's that been like for you?
Well, at the start of quarantine, no gyms were open or anything, so I was just working out at home, doing lots of cardio, lots of body weight, just grinding, and then gyms opened up, so it made it a little easier. And then just on Wednesday, I got on ice for the first time in the last 4.5 months, so it was a little rusty, but not too bad, but been shooting some pucks too, so it's been all right.
Fair enough. And same question for you, Kev?
I was kind of fortunate to have a pretty good setup at home. In our garage, we had a bit of a gym and a net and some shooting tiles. So every day, me and my sister would shoot pucks and work out together. And that was kind of the deal for a few months. And then once the gyms opened up back in Wilcox, I've been going out there every day with my sister and going on the ice too. So yeah, it's been about 2 weeks on the ice now, and it's kind of all the rust is shaking off back to normal. So that's good. And it's just kind of been a lot of at home, but it was a good setup, so it worked out well.
Good to know. Yeah,
we actually have our own little shooting center in our barn because I live on a farm, so we just set one up in the barn.
Nice. That's awesome. You guess you guys know all about the things that Notre Dame has set up for you guys to work, the shooting galleries and the gym and the ice time and everything that you guys have sort of at your disposal at Notre Dame. So it's good that you have some setups that kind of continues with your process and your progress, in that regard. Blake, Kev kind of knows because he has a little bit of junior experience, but, I guess sort of what you've been able to ask maybe from Kev obviously a whole bunch of your teammates on the Hounds last year, different ones got call-ups and are off to different junior A camps around Canada and the States and whatever. But I guess I should ask, what are you expecting about the jump from midget to junior? Because obviously it's a real thing.
Yeah, I'm expecting it to be quite a bit faster. Like lots of the APs were saying, it's quite a bit faster, a lot of heavier hitting, everyone's heavier, everyone's older. So I think I've gained quite a few pounds this off season. I've been working on gaining some more weight and getting faster. So I think I'm up for the challenge and I think I'll be ready.
Nice. And Kev, obviously you had those two games with us last year, scored up just a gorgeous goal where the goalie just fired it right off your, I don't know if it was your face or what it was, but it went in. They're all beautiful. But you've looked very good. Fit right in, I think, in terms of your level of play in those two games. Kindersley, Balfour's two not easy places to go. Just recap those two games for you. How you felt how, what you take from that experience, heading into this season, knowing that you've been there a bit.
Well, I honestly didn't even know I was going to be APing until the day of. So when I got on the bus, I was obviously really nervous, but Brett and Phil made me feel welcome. And then players, like, they were really nice to be with. So it was pretty good there. And then the games, it was definitely faster and bigger. And obviously I'm not that big, so it was kind of a bit scary, but I got used to it real quick. And I think it was good experience to get under my belt. And now I'm kind of know what I'm going into. So I think it was really good.
Yeah, it was great to have you. Yeah, I'll post a video of that goal that I was talking about against Kindersley, I believe, in yeah. Kindersley. And boy, what a performance by Riley Kahanek in that game in net too. Got to mention salmon arm goaltender Riley Kahanek, because he was pretty unbelievable. Anyways, Blake, you know, obviously both of you know Devin Pratt very well. Obviously, you guys played for him last year and beyond. But Blake, Dev is a guy that prides himself on pushing midget players very hard, pushing them basically as hard as midget as junior players and harder. And you know, I think his track record of sending guys on from that program to junior A and junior major junior and whatever, it really speaks for itself, obviously. If you could, you know, just sort of say what you kind of learned from Dev and, you know, how well you feel like he prepared you and this and him and Kev White, obviously, I've got to mention Kev as well, and all the people that do a great job in the hockey office at Notre Dame. But obviously Dev and Kev really had, you know, the reins of that program for you guys last year and the years before. But yeah, just what did you kind of learn from Dev and Kev about getting ready for the next level?
Yeah, I think they prepared us very well for junior A, and they just concentrate really on the details of the game, just every little spot you need to be in, like on the forecheck or wherever it is in zone. And I think that'll help you out a lot in junior when the plays are faster and you need to be in the right spots. And yeah, they did quite a few like different skills in practice. So yeah, that I think that'll transition into junior A, and we did lots of battling and stuff. So I guess we'll have an advantage against bigger guys battling it out every day in practice, 5 days a week. So I think that'll go a long ways.
Yeah, for sure, Kev. You know, both of you guys both played for Argos, I think, and Hounds over your time, and I think it's great when guys kind of have that, you know, varying experience. But you know, obviously for you, Kev, you know, you went from, you know, being, I guess, a big dog with the Argos, and then you come in and you have all these expectations last year with the Hounds, and you know, obviously it seems like it worked out. You were the leading scorer for a lot of the year. Obviously Dumb decided to figure it out, but boy is he a heck of a player too. Obviously Brooks doesn't just pick up anybody, so good for Dumb. But you know, it seemed like that step was one that you took pretty well last year, and that skill kind of showed through, and obviously playing with great players like Blake certainly helped, I'm sure. You know, just talk about what kind of clicked for you last year, how you kind of find that success to be such a dangerous guy on what was a good Hounds team that, honestly, between the three of us, nobody's going to be watching. You guys should have gone further than you did in the playoffs. But I guess a lot of people should say that, given that it was kind of stuck and yeah, whatever. But that's another conversation. Take it away, Kev.
Well, I think first few games was a bit of a struggle for me, but that was I kind of shook off the rust. And then I think the biggest thing was just confidence. Like with Prodder, he gave me lots of encouragement and kind of just told me to calm down and figure my stuff out. And I think it came naturally after that. Like he was really good with that, and it helped me kind of gain my confidence. And then I felt like more risky to make plays and try new things that worked out. So yeah, I think it was really good, and I think confidence was a big thing there.
Yeah, for sure. And I think also, you know, the fact that you guys had that familiarity with campus and with Varse, with you know, managing homework and school and playing and everything, you know, it's always an advantage when you have another year, I think, of experience of it. I guess guys just get more and more used to it every year. But Blake, you know, I gotta ask you, you know, obviously you were at Notre Dame, you left, played a year with Swift Current Midgets, and then came back. And obviously we're all glad you did. But, you know, just talk about your Notre Dame, I guess, experience so far. What is it about Notre Dame that, you know, made you want to, you know, come back, stick with the program, the process of constantly, you know, getting better over time, and everything? What is it about Notre Dame that kind of keeps you here?
Well, I think I love the idea of struggle and emerge at Notre Dame. I'm kind of a grinding type guy in the gym and in the shooting center and ice every day. So I think Notre Dame has everything you need to get better. I don't know what else they could have to make you better. Like, you can, if you want, you can just grind 24/7, eat, sleep, breathe hockey. So I think that's one of the main points of coming back, and I think they have everything you need to become a great hockey player. So
yeah, Coach Brett and Coach Phil are gonna love your attitude, I tell you that much. as will I. Kev, obviously, you know, again, you've been around Notre Dame too. You know, it wasn't always smooth for you, but that's the Notre Dame, right? Struggle and emerge, and it feels like you know, you both seem really primed to be impact rookies in this in the SJHL this year coming up. But again, sort of similar question, Kev. What do you feel like Notre Dame's done for you as a human being first, and as a hockey player second?
Well, I think I've definitely grown over my 3 years here, and I don't know. I think just like, everyone's there kind of to do the same thing. Everyone's there to get better. So it's kind of a good environment. And I think that kind of helped me like realize that I need to work hard and stuff. And it helped me obviously get a bit better at hockey. And I don't know. The people there that's kind of what made it was a big factor in what made me want to come back. It's just like a family there. Everyone's there. Yeah, I think that helped me kind of become a better person. And like, obviously the gym and the shooting center and the ice is all like within walking distance from the dorm. So it's real easy to get better there. And yeah, I'm looking forward to another year of that for sure.
Yeah, sweet. Well, let's shift gears here a little bit. Obviously we've talked the business, I guess, a little bit, but Blake, you know, I asked you what you were doing in terms of working, grinding over this time, but, you know, everybody's had lots of time for Netflix and for PS4 or whatever it is that you're into. So what have you been doing for fun? Who have you been doing it with? Especially now that it's been legal to, you know, see people and do some things in our beautiful province. Yeah, Blake, what have you been doing for fun to just, I guess, relax and enjoy yourself this last little while?
Well, mostly I've just been working on the farm and working with my brothers and my dad. So that's taken up quite a bit of time. And just last week I went on a 4-day fishing trip, like way up north. And we had to take a plane to get there. So that was lots of fun. Got to go on a float plane up in Missy Lake, so that was lots of fun. And we've just been hanging around Mooseman and going to the lake, and not much else.
That's awesome. What kind of farm is it?
We do land and cattle, so
There you go. And also I have an inside tip, Blake, that when you were little, you were babysat by Marianne Gibson, who's a good friend of mine. So
oh yeah.
Small world. Talk about that another time. And Kev, same question for you.
Well, the first few months I was kind of just hanging out at home and doing as much as I can for hockey, but you can only do so much, and then you take a break sometime. So a little bit of Netflix and video games. But now that now that everything's opened up, we've been spending a lot of time out at Echo Lake. We have a campsite there. And yeah, that opened up on July 1st, I think, or honestly, I don't really remember when it opened up, but it was a while ago. And we've been spending a lot of time there and yeah, just kind of spending time at the lake and relaxing a bit. So that's about it.
For sure. Blake, give me one Netflix show I should watch. On the spot.
Probably, I can't even remember what it's called. I haven't been watching that many movies, actually.
It's good.
Well, I did just watch a movie, not a show, but I watched one that was like similar to Jaws. I forget what it's called.
Okay.
Yeah, it was pretty good.
Okay. And Kev, what are you watching, Kev?
I watched a lot of The Office. Like, I've rewatched it a few times throughout this quarantine. And then when The Last Dance came out, that Michael Jordan documentary, I watched that. And I really liked that. But I think the go-to is The Office. I watched that a lot.
Nice. That's great. For sure. And then just the last question, I guess. First of all, for you, Blake, you know, I'm sure a lot of people that pay attention to the Junior A Hounds are familiar with the Midget Hounds and the Midget Argos and whatnot, but, you know, not everybody. So I guess, you know, you mentioned it briefly where you're from, but I just would like to give guys an opportunity to say, you know, where they're from, you know, who their parents are, what they do, siblings, just kind of introduce yourself, so to speak, to the Notre Dame Hounds Junior A friends and family.
Yeah, so I'm from Mooseman, Saskatchewan. It's on the northeast side of Saskatchewan, like right on the border. So I live on a farm like 15 minutes outside of Mooseman, which is like a mile away from the border. So I don't know. I haven't been self-quarantining when I farm on the Manitoba side, but I have three siblings. I have two brothers and one sister. My older brother went to ND for 1 year, and my younger sister is coming this year along with Kevin's sister. And my parents, my dad works on the farm. He runs a farm. And then my mom works in and teaches. So yeah, that's a little bit about my family.
Yeah, of course. And obviously, Mooseman has been the site for a couple Hounds neutral site games against Weyburn last couple of years, which have been, you know, very, very fun. And I've definitely enjoyed broadcasting from there and eating the Red Barn Door, Red Barn Door. What's the name of that restaurant?
Just the Red Barn.
The Red Barn. I don't know why I throw in the word door. but delicious. Always so delicious at that place. And obviously the fans really come out in Mooseman. So awesome. And,
yeah.
I know Mooseman's brought some people, sent some people to Notre Dame. Also, I know Melville just signed Kyle Bocek, I believe, who's also from Mooseman and others. So little community that seems to produce a lot of good talent there. Very cool. Kev, same question.
Well, I grew up in Tisdale. I played some minor hockey there. And then grade five, I moved to Regina. So I would have been, 10, I think. Yeah. And I think it would have been 10. I moved to Regina with my dad's job. He was an RCMP officer. And then shortly after we moved here, he switched over to SAS Power. So now he works with them. And my mom works with Thrive Wealth Management. So she's like an investment planner. And then my sister Kyra, as Blake mentioned, is going into grade 10 at Notre Dame. She'll go there. And then my brother Ethan is going into his second year of university at University of Regina. And yeah, that's about it. Got two dogs too. Just got a new puppy. Started quarantine actually. Nice. And yeah, that's about it.
I hope you didn't name it Corona.
His name's Winnie.
There you go. I've been known to be yelled at by Hounds Junior A players at Varus for making terrible jokes. So maybe you guys will join that list. Talking about you, Gabriel LeBlanc. Great. Well, Craig Parrott, I'm sure, hopefully he'll pay attention and see if he can add your sisters to his great team. Obviously, Craig, the female hockey coordinator at Notre Dame, does an outstanding job as well, and I gotta give him a shout out. But Blake Rasmussen, Kevin Anderson, I'm Jamie Neugebauer. This has been the first Hounds Junior A chat. Thank you guys so much for joining me.
Thanks again.
Thank you for having us.